Hello, welcome to the lesson on Linux commands part 3. In this lesson, we are going to explore more commands. Right, so now we are going to change the directory. So we want to change to home directory. To change the home directory, we can use cd and then this tilde symbol. Okay, so this symbol actually represents home directory. So now we will be in the home directory. So what is the home directory? Slash home slash py is the home directory, right? So there is another command to go to the home directory, like for example cd appleton. Now we are in appleton directory. To change to a home directory, you can use cd slash home slash py is one way. Okay, so you can either use this particular command to go to home directory, or you can use this command to go to the home directory, right? So there are, you know, two commands which will give you the same effect for the py user, right? So far we have used relative path. We can even use absolute path. For example cd, so type here all of you cd slash. Now this is the absolute path, so you can see the files present here. Okay, so this is the bin directory, boot directory, dev, etc, home, lib, lost plus found. These are all, you know, main system files, all of you. So main files. Okay, so now you can see the home directory here, home, right? Suppose, you know, if you want to go to home, cd home, so you'll see here slash home. Now we are in the home directory. You can check in the home directory, you will see the py user, py. Okay, so now you can go to cd py. Now you are in the current, you know, working directory. That is actually, you can see now tilde symbol here, right? Is that clear to all of you? Right, so now what we are going to do is, so you can actually list files by using ls. So you can see here list of files, right? Most commands have additional parameters or switches that can be used to turn on different behaviors. For example, ls and then hyphen l. This command is very helpful. So we are using here l is the switch. This is mainly to see the detailed listing. Like you can see the file sizes, you can see the dates, you can see the permissions. Just press enter here. Now you will see now the files, list of files, but you will see here the size, date, and also the permissions here, right? So here you will see there are some files which are belonging to root files. Some files are belonging to py, right? So you can see here all of you, right? Is that clear to you? So you can use this L switch in order to see the detailed listing. And also there are some files which are invisible. So how to check the invisible files? You can check the invisible files by adding another switch here, a. So now ls space hyphen la. Now press enter. Now you can find some invisible files here, right? So previously these dot files are not available, right? Dot sqlite history, dot themes, dot thony, dot pnc. These files are not actually visible previously, right? When you see here, there are no dot files, but now you can see here all these hidden files now. Is that clear to you? So in this way you can use these switches. Now change directory to appleton. Okay, so type here all of you cd appleton. So now we are changing to appleton directory. Now we are in appleton directory. Now you can check the files here. So what are the files present in it? So we have innovations. So change directory to innovations, cd innovations. Now we have a file in it. Let us check the file. So the file is hello.txt. How to remove this file? So to remove the files, we have a command called as rm. So rm space hello.txt. So this will remove or delete the file from the directory. You can see here now ls, when you check the list of files present in this directory, you see that hello.txt is not present, right? The same way you can actually delete directories also. To delete directories, we have a command called as rmdir. Okay, so for example, you want to delete innovations directory. So change directory. So cd. So now we are in Appleton directory. Okay, so now check the list of directories present in Appleton. So we have a one directory in Appleton, that is innovations. So how to delete this innovations directory from the Appleton? Okay, to do that, simply you have to use rmdir. Rmdir is the command to delete directories. Okay, so rmdir space innovations. Now check here ls. Now inside of Appleton there is no directory, right? Yes or no? We have deleted it. So where is Appleton exactly? So if you go to home/py, you will see here Appleton, but there is no file in it because we deleted, right, by using rmdir, right, all of you, right? So now you know how to use rmdir and rm. Okay, rm is mainly to delete files, rmdir is to delete directories.